Dr. Evans here with a couple of quick tips for the equilibrium experiment. Keep in mind that there are two parts to this experiment. In part A, we'll be using a relatively dilute solution of iron 3 cation and a relatively concentrated solution of thiocyanate anion to produce the iron thiocyanate product quantitatively. And these two solutions, the dilute iron and the concentrated thiocyanate, are relatively special. If you use them in part B, which are what I call the equilibrium runs, you'll get poor results. So for example, here's what test tube 7, which is an equilibrium run, a part B run, is supposed to look like. It's got this nice kind of mild orangish color to it. If in test tube 7 you end up using the dilute iron solution instead of the stock iron solution, the 0.0025 molar stock solution, you end up with something that looks like this, which is unsurprisingly colorless. Right? This is transparent because there's very little iron 3 in here because you use the diluted rather than the stock, more concentrated iron 3 solution. And so not much product forms, and we see basically a colorless solution that looks a lot like water, and for the most part, really, this is water. Now, if you use the extra concentrated thiocyanate solution instead of the, again, the 0.0025 molar stock, you end up with something that looks like this. And what you should notice about this tube is that it's much darker than the orange that the test tube 7 really should look like. So what it should look like, you see on the left here, and what you get if you use the overly concentrated, the 0.5 molar thiocyanate, you can see on the right. So make sure to use 0.0025 molar thiocyanate rather than the much more concentrated 0.5 molar solution in part B of the experiment.